Alright, I'm gonna get started on part 8 here. It's just started to get cloudy again. It's been raining a bunch yesterday and this morning. Not supposed to rain anymore, so it's a bit windy, but that's okay. I'm just gonna assume it won't rain and I'll be fine. Okay. I dressed up all my antler bits, my indirect punch, my two pressure flakers. This one I ground a bit finer for taking the nice flakes off, pressure flakes, and then this one is kind of the scruncher, you know, for shaping platforms and just taking off lots of small flakes. So at this stage, I want to focus on finishing up the base completely, I think, and then I'll make the blade to match. More or less just do everything with pressure flaking at this point, although I would like to set up a nice big flake to take rid, or you know, get rid of this high spot that I left in the middle. And I think as I work on the base, I'm going to try and take off kind of a fluting flake to flatten out this face, because it's kind of high in the middle, but I don't really want to take any more big ones from the sides. So yeah, I'm going to start by taking out the kind of, you know, the, can't even really call them notches, but on the pedernales point, it's got these almost like huge corner notches that sometimes come to a point like this, sometimes they're just straight, and then in the middle here it's, you know, bifurcated, so it comes up really high. Yeah.
All right.
Well, that's a good start. Platform's not the best there, but get it from the other side. Stuff is kind of difficult to pressure flake. Yeah, I can take the odd indirect flake every now and then when I get a nice chance.
To try and keep everything on camera in frame a little better. came across really well.
Hope the sun doesn't blind out the camera. Didn't realize the umbrella wasn't right over top. Oops. There we go, that's a better angle with the pressure flaker. Couldn't get enough power into it the other way. try and get another indirect flake here. Maybe even one more if I push it a little. Not quite enough, but I can do the same from the other edge. whole video might just be about shaping the base up, huh? Taking a while. One side, I can fix that up a little bit more later when I have a finer pressure flaker. I would like that to come up a little bit. It should come up, and then these sides should come straight down. Yes, I can take some big ones from there if I can. Straighten up at the opposite face first.
maybe? Might have to just a little bit raise this one up to match this after all is said and done. Quite enough there.
once already. How'd that happen? Definitely gonna have to put a lot more work into this base. So, yeah, just the base here is gonna be a two-parter. Parts 8 and 9 of the total series. All about that base. About that base. And that wind. What the heck is going on today? Now, if I've set this up properly, I'm hoping I can get some sort of flute that comes up here and takes out part of this high spot. That'd be really cool. I don't know, maybe I can try that and then finish the video. Gotta set that up first. That was a little too much for a platform isolating flake. Yeah, this isn't gonna run too far, but we'll try and get something out of it without splitting it in half. Wish me luck. Cool. Didn't go that far, like I thought, but that's fine. I'm just gonna go for it and try and finish up, at least, you know, finish up this base to about, let's say, 90%. Of what it will be eventually. Thinking about trying to get another indirect flake to really thin this base down. That worked out, quite nicely, actually. Cool. I think that's a fairly authentic look for a Pedernales. Kind of has these little thinning flakes. Not quite flutes, you know, but basal thinning flakes.
Does that look straight?
More or less. This one might be a hair too low. Yeah, that's better. I think that's a lot more even now. Okay. I don't need to, 100% finish the base before I start the base, the blade part, rather. I almost took too much off of there. Close ones. Forgot I was gonna get my calipers out here and start really measuring everything, but oh well, next time. Video is way too long now. So just can't help myself. Okay, yeah. Well, it's not 100% finished, but it's a good start on the base, I think. I don't know. It's a little bit off. Oh well, I still need to bring these in. Once I straighten those out, it'll look better, I think. Yeah, I was debating doing more work on this right now, but I need to go take a break, eat something, sharpen up my pressure flaker real fine so I can get it in there. I think I do want to finish this base completely, or more or less, a bit more anyways, before I work on the blade part. So yeah, super long video, but keep working on the base in the next one, and then hopefully I can start the blade. If I can put 10 more minutes into this base, I think that's good, and then finish this up in another couple parts to the video series.
yeah, big project. Going well so far. But yeah, that's it for this one. As always, thanks for watching. Catch you next time. Cheers.